Exactly 6 hours and 29 minutes ago, I came up with a genius idea. The plan is to build 10 mechanical fingers that will sit on top of my actual fingers and will be controlled, but all I'm gonna have to do is move my finger down and it'll bend. So we need 10 of those, 2 thumbs, 4 regular looking fingers, and then we're gonna hook it all up to a system that'll attach to your wrist, so when you move the fingers, it will kind of move on your wrist. I looked at some images online of how to do the linkage mechanisms. So using that, I made a couple prototypes. The first prototype I have is this gear finger. So essentially when this gear turns, the finger will close. The issue with this, it isn't controlled by my finger moving. So then I spent like another hour designing this, which is the actual thing that is going to work. And the way it works, when these two pieces hinge, the finger closes. So as long as this white piece rests on my hand and the rest rests on my finger, we should have a nice closing finger. So the attachment point has to be Lego. It has to connect to these studs down here, and it has to fit without being too uncomfortable. And then I stumbled on something genius, which is essentially, you should take a 1x3 and 2 of these little bracket pieces without the crooks in the walls, and then you just put that like that. You can see we now have a perfect little ring, and now, if we just get a couple more of these, that is absolutely perfect, and look at that, it covers all your fingers, you can do any of the hand gestures you would do before, they don't get in the way at all. So if we attach this to this, if I open and close my hand, the device closes, and that is really cool, look at that. So now we need to build this 7 more times, and then come up with the design for the thumbs, and then figure out a way to attach it to our hand, pretty much. We have to build a thing on our wrist that holds these, but you can see that is how it will work with that. A little more difficult than I expected. I feel like Wolverine right now. Look at how weird that is. Okay, so the question, we need to move this one. So they're a little finicky. We need to figure out a couple things. One of them is that they don't open up all the way. Maybe some rubber bands or something right there, but you can see they're just not super great. This is where we have to figure out the bugs and I get a little discouraged, but then somehow it all switches around and starts working. I'm like, what? No way. The problem I'm having is that these are so thin and we need the space, so when I attach this to here, it easily breaks off, especially when I bend my fingers. So I had this thought. We use Lego stickers. I have a ton of these. I save them every time I buy a Lego set. And so what we can do is we can take these out, we can cut them, or we can just put them on there. And then we should have a pretty solid connection there that will stop breaking as much, because that's just really annoying. This crazy cool desk is the FlexiSpot Kana Pro Bamboo Standing Desk EC8. And what makes it really cool is that it can do this. This desk is completely height adjustable. Check this out. If I want to be a sitting desk, I can adjust it to where I want to be. So if my chair is a little lower, I just bring the desk down. I used to edit sitting down a lot and I've been getting a lot of neck pain. So that's the reason I wanted to switch to something like this. So when FlexiSpot reached out, I was like, heck yeah. And a cool thing is that you can save positions in the desk. So if I wanted to go to a standing position, I just hit the other one. And you can see right here, I've set it to be perfect for my height. You want to be 90 degrees with your shoulders. You can see I'm now 90 degrees and my hands are resting on it. And if I grow taller, I just put the desk up more. Because you know that's going to happen. I'm a tall guy. It also has a feature where if there's something above it or below it, if it jolts at all or gets stuck on anything, it'll raise back up. So that's a nice safety feature. Another thing I like is that there's a USB port, which allows you to plug in things like your iPhone or your iPad or whatever. The top of this desk is made out of sustainable bamboo, and honestly, it is a tough desk. It's really nice design, it's really clean and tucked away. You can choose the color for the legs between black and white. You can customize the desk size to be smaller or bigger. There's even an option that has like a cutout right here so you can really get into your work. Go check out the Kana Pro Bamboo Standing Desk EC8. Check out the link in the description. Let's get back to the build. All right, so we've been working on this for 4 hours. Let me show you what I have. I built all 10 fingers. They're comfortable and they fit like this and they work. I kind of have a thumb design right here. So essentially it's one of these fingers, but I just made it a little shorter. And so the next step is to attach everything at the base and create kind of like a wrist thing that we can hold onto. You can see here, this thing is pretty sick. We're gonna add some rubber grippers because this is very janky, but it works, and that's pretty sick. We have to mimic what we did on these on the other claws, which are just not very great. Let's build those up real quick, and then we'll create a mechanism that'll attach all of these little sticks to the wrist and make them a little bit flexible so they can slide. Okay, so for the strap, we're going to add a few of these, and these are really cool because they have a little ball joint on the end, so we can attach these in Technic holes, like that. And then, we come over here to our joints, and we need ball joints, we'll grab these. We can take one of these, and we can create a strap around the Technic by just clicking this in here and adding a bunch more of those. And connect them using these little things at the bottom. Boom. Now, if we hook this onto this, strap this around, click it like that. Beautiful. We need one more strap right here. Six. You loop it around this way, click. This one, loop that around that way, click. Gorgeous. Put those on top. Put this right here. On top of that. See the hinging there, and that's just from the lever. So that's pretty awesome. Put the fingers through. If we just swing this around here. And now, as you can see, we have Lego mechanical exoskeleton hands. And these can be very useful. For what, you may ask? Well, we're about to try and glue two Lego bricks together. And then, just that. Glue spilling out. Just dab some on there. Hey, fun fact, it is not a good idea to do that with glue. Never mind. Look at that, they're like cyborg hands. That's just so awesome. Like, I didn't think these would turn out as good as they did. Sometimes the thumb and this finger get stuck together, but it's fine. It's just like, you make this. It's kind of cool because they follow exactly what you do with your finger. So if I bend this finger goes up. And kind of the last two fingers are a little attached too, just like on your real hand. And then the thumb just like barely bends, but I think it's enough to just kind of help you pick up whatever you're trying to pick up. Let's see if we can pick up a fruit soda. Come on, you can do this. Oh. Honestly, you just pick that up with your regular hand because it's still inside of the glove. I don't know why I'm trying so hard to do that. Just a quick disclaimer, do not do anything I'm doing. I'm a trade professional and I'm using as much safety precaution as I can. This is called dry ice, and you can't touch it to your fingers. You have to be using a glove, which is why we have designed these Lego gloves so that we can still have our fingers open, but move the dry ice with the gloves. It sounds kind of stupid. That's because it kind of is. You can see that my fingers are nowhere near the tips of these fingers. So we're gonna pick up a piece of dry ice and put it into this nice bowl of water. But first, always wear eye protection, even if it's only with one hand.
Okay, here we go. We're gonna take our dry ice, pick it up. And you can see, we're not touching it with our fingers, so. Pick up the dry ice. Just like this. And look at that. We didn't have to use our real hand at all. We just used the one with the glove on it. And now, we can even take it out without it touching our fingers. Actually, it might be really hard. Yeah, we didn't need to do that. Anyway.
Okay, guys, it's official. It can move dry ice. So essentially, it's not very efficient at it, but you know, it serves its purpose. Huge thanks to FlexiSpot for sponsoring this video. Go click the link in the description to check out their desk. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, you'll probably enjoy the video where I built myself out of Lego. Super cool. Click it. It's right here. Thanks so much for watching. My name's Riley. I'll talk to you next one.